Bueno, orain Monika Morenoren txanda da. Bera polimeroen kimikan doktorea da. Polimeroekin egiten du lan, proiektuekin, komunikazioan, sare sozialetan eta bar. Eta lehen oianak kontatu digun bezala inglesa da zientziaren hizkuntza eta Monikak ba inglesez hitz egingo digu.
Eskerrik asko Larrai. Bueno, ingeles ez dingo, vale? Monika Moreno Rodríguez, my name is Monika Moreno, and I work in a polymer center here in San Sebastian that is called Polymat. Well, I grew up in a small village near Salamanca, and at high school I decided to specialize in sciences, probably like most of you. And then at the end of high school, I didn't know what to do. I like teaching, but I was also curious about sciences. So I decided to study chemistry. And in Salamanca, we have quite a nice university and faculties. So I studied in Salamanca, in the Faculty of Chemistry. During my degree, in the last year, I went on Erasmus. And as Jana and Elisa said before, it was really enriching and exciting experience. So if you have the chance to go abroad, to travel, please do it along your life and your career. So I did my Erasmus in Bristol University in the UK for the whole academic year. And it was, I would say, a breaking point in my life because it was really, really exciting. I had the chance to do a research project on molecular simulation, hard sphere crystallization, and so on. So I work in the lab, and I also was doing some simulation in the computer. I work in a multicultural group, as you can see here, and it was really nice experience. So after that, I finished the degree and I had to decide what to do next. So like you, we had different opportunities. I could do education, industry, or I could do a PhD thesis. So after my experience on Erasmus, I went to the third option. And I decided to do a PhD. I got a grant here at the University of the Basque Country in Polymat. And I was doing a very nice project trying to replace the current petroleum-based materials for other derivatives, such as the sunflower oil derivatives. During my PhD, I also did an internship, another stay, again in the UK, this time in Windsor. And I went to a company. It was the first time that I worked in a company that is really different than working in academia, that being in a university. Different environment, but really, really nice at the same time. So, and after this period, that I got graduated, similar picture than another colleague here. And it was very nice. I mean, I finished my PhD, but then again, the same dilemma. So what to do next after the PhD? It's all the time during your life and your career, you will have to take decisions. And again, it was another one. I could go to education or academy in the university, go to industry or continue doing research. I didn't really know what to do. So I had the opportunity to continue doing research. But at the same time, I started doing project management. What is that? So that is that you can combine working in the lab and at the same time, managing those research projects and managing people. So I could, as you can see here in this picture, so you can do really networking, you can travel, you organize meetings, and you know a different or many different scientific communities to work with and many different research projects. And from 2016 to today, right now, I'm in charge of the project management at Polymat, but I'm also in charge of the communication and outreach activities, dissemination. So what is that? What we do in Polymat? In Polymat, we do polymers. I guess you all know what a polymer is, or at least a plastic. That is commonly, polymers are commonly known as plastics. So we work with polymers, and we try to make polymers, sustainable polymers, to make polymers recyclable. We do polymers for batteries, for membranes, for biomedicine, for many different applications. But if we do this research and we do not communicate to people, we are doing nothing. We need to tell people, to tell the society, and to tell you what we are doing in the lab. So this is what I do. What I do is I'm running the social networks at Polymath, like a community manager, so LinkedIn, Twitter, Instagram, and so on. And I'm also in charge of the public visits, of scholar visits in our center. And this year, or next year, we will also coordinate the Emakumeak Zientzian program that perhaps, I don't know if you have heard of it, and we collaborate with Eureka, for instance, and with other research centers that are here. So what I want to translate you here today is that you can do a scientific career, but the only alternative is not working in the lab. I mean, you can end up doing many other things. So you can do research, and at the same time, you can end up doing a social community manager, social networks, dissemination, communication to the society. That is really, really exciting and an enriching experience. And finally, well, I would like to join my colleagues to again say that we would like to keep Eureka alive. So Eureka, be seated, and thank you all for the excellent work that you are doing in this year.